Well, we have to understand what a demur to evidence is. A demur to evidence is something that an accused would file in a criminal case asking the court, dismiss the case, the prosecution's evidence is not enough, so it should be dismissed in my favor. So the Sonbigan Bayan did not agree with the royal. It said that, no, the evidence is sufficient, but with the Supreme Court decision, it would appear that the Supreme Court is siding with the former president and saying that, yes, the prosecution's evidence is not enough, and so we should dismiss the case.
Not enough to establish a case against her, but now the ombudsman has said that just June 1, they submitted 600 pieces of documentary evidence, additional evidence, and 46 transcripts of hearings in the Sandigan Bayan. How can this be insufficiency of evidence?
Well, it really boils down to the quality of evidence that you're presenting. While they may have presented 600 pieces of documents, the question is, do these establish the guilt of the president? And the Sandigan Bayan said that, yes, it does, because in the documents, it shows that she signed them and she approved the release of the CIF. So with the Supreme Court decision, the Supreme Court is saying, even with the signature found in these documents, that's not enough.
Because the argument of a royal camp was that they didn't show that that money went into her pocket.
Yes, yes, that's their argument. Although if you look at the plunder law, it's not necessary to show that money came to your account. There's also a provision which says if you're able to show that an accused participated in order for another one to amass amounts, that's enough to convict you for the crime of plunder.
That's the position of the ombudsman. They were saying that they were able to establish conspiracy here with the other participants.
Yes, that's the stand of the ombudsman. But given the Supreme Court decision, it would seem that the Supreme Court is asking for more. So it's asking for additional evidence apart from the former president's signature found in those documents to prove that there is indeed conspiracy.
Now, the Sandigan Bayan denied her petition for bail, denied her demur of evidence on the ground precisely of having enough evidence against her. Now, in overturning this, has the Supreme Court become a trier of facts then?
It would seem so. Although the former president went up by way of a petition for certiorari, meaning Arroyo's camp is saying that there was grave abuse of discretion. And in that case, the Supreme Court would have to look into the records and check whether indeed the Sandigan Bayan overstepped its jurisdiction or acted without jurisdiction.
Given the dismissal of this case on this particular ground, can another case still be filed against her in relation to the PCSO
Definitely,
scandal?
Definitely, there may still be a case that may be filed, but on different acts, on the basis of different facts, different evidence, but not on the 336 million pesos, which was released from 2008 onwards.
Because the ombudsman is preparing another case against her in relation to the PCSO Intelligence Fund.
Yes, I believe that it pertains to the from 2004 up to 2007, and it involves 57 million pesos. So that can still be filed because it's hinged on a different set of facts.
How about her pending case in connection with the ZTE deal? Now, no, that's an entirely different transaction. However, they also filed a demur of evidence on that case. Similar strategy.
Yes, it's a similar strategy. I believe that because under the criminal proceedings, if after the prosecution presents its evidence, an accused can opt to file a demur to evidence. Now, whether or not this will be granted in favor of Arroyo, that remains to be seen. Notwithstanding the Supreme Court decision, the Sandigan Bayan would have to evaluate the evidence that has been presented. And it's not necessarily bound by the Supreme Court decision, given that it's set on different facts from the decision of the Supreme Court.
Unless when the decision has yet to come out, the entire text of it, but it might have created a different standard when it comes to identifying what is sufficiency or insufficiency of evidence.
I would agree with that. Given the situation right now, it would have raised the benchmark on what would be the minimum amount of evidence needed to convict one of the crime of plunder, especially in this case when the evidence, notwithstanding the fact that the evidence shows that the former president did indeed sign those documents releasing the CIF, So the prosecutors would now have to reevaluate the existing evidence and would have to dig up additional evidence to show more than just participation through signature in documents.
Which means more work for the Office of the Ombudsman. Thank you so much, Aldrich, for being with us today.